Here's gloves for Bob Wilson. All right, we got him. Next up, what are you giving away? Nice Jet Tribe helmet bag. And it is full of Southern California oxygen and a full sticker kit. Whoops, you released the oxygen. Well, we still have the stupid kit, sticker kit. Sleazy for me to say. It's okay. Yeah, right? Ah, Jet Tribe helmet bag going to Steve Gerling. Steve Gerling. All right. More giveaways. Faster giveaways. More cowbell. Juniors to the line. We've got an extra large Jet Tribe t-shirt for... Shannon
Harden.
Herenders. Shannon Harden. Shannon Harden, come on down. You got an extra large t-shirt, or that could be a very short dress. Gonna be stunning either way. Next up. Oh, I'm keeping that. What size is it? No way. Well, I'm not saying I'll keep it.
You say that we'll pull your name as a winning ticket?
Well, we'll see. All right, up next.
Don K.
Jet Tribe. Dan K.
Oh, Dan Nolden.
You got a Jet Tribe bag full of goodies.
Yeah, get this one. Get this last one.
Oh, we did? Oh, that's right. Hey, Dan, remember what happened last time? You better get up here and get your gift before we give it to somebody else.
You snooze, funny. You lose.
That's right. But we do appreciate the donation. Wow. Today? Yesterday, Dan Nolden. Wow, that is a good group of stuff. You're not Dan Nolden. You're the messenger. Give this boy a prize. What else have we got? CZ, you're going to say, welcome.
Bob Wilson.
Getting a Jet Tribe outfit.
Very nice.
We'll put the gloves in the...
Gloves in the bag.
B. Wilson. Junior's on the line. Junior's on the line. Next up. Nice set of RS15 Jet Tribe racing shorts, size 38. Sweet. Half my waist size. No. Christopher, grab one for us. What's the name? Mike Tinsley. Or is that Michelle Tinsley? Malia Tinsley.
M. Tinsley.
Tinsley. Get on over there and grab it. Double X. Find somebody else.
Thank you, though, Dan. I appreciate it.
Yeah, XL looks like a crop top on me. It's not a good sign. Hey, and thanks for your contribution, by the way. You might want to go not go too far. I have the feeling there's going to be more tickets in there.
All right. Junior Ace out of the gate. Looks like Talon Chambers. Have to follow them when they come around. Missed them on the far side. Do you guys see? Nope. Kind of. Well, you got your young eyes. Tell me who comes around the corner first. Talon Chambers with the early lead. Check it as he comes around. Talon Volan, hole shot master in this one. The 831 gets a green flag. Talon Chambers out front behind him. His buddy, Seth Furman. Followed by Dominic Kennedy and Tyler Tolan. Tyler Tolan on that loud X2. That thing is a rocket ship. And look out, Dominic Kennedy, because Tyler Tolan is a knocking on your door. With all right, who's up next? Junior B's to the line. I'm going by the paperwork. All right, hey. All right, moto number two, race number one, Sports It 1200 GP. We need Doug Wolf, Tamachi Yamamoto, Jason, Psycho Ward, Michael McFarlane, Jack Arlick, and Norm Yee to the line. We also could use some holders. Talon Chambers coming across, getting a white flag. About a half a lap lead, Seth Furman. Look out, Seth Furman, last lap, but here comes Tyler Tolan. Tyler Tolan is on the gas. Look out, Seth Furman. Dominic Kennedy. Boy, I tell you what, that kid looks good on that number seven ski.
bend and break. Say a prayer, but let the good times roll. In case God doesn't show. And I want these words to make things right, but it's the wrongs that make the words come to life. But who does he think he is?
If that's the worst you got, better put your fingers back to the key.
All right, last trip through, Norm Yee on the water. All right, here we are, race moto number two, race number one, Sports It 1200 GP. On the number 30, well actually let's call it off by race went moto number one. First overall, Thomas Pagen. Second overall was Doug Wolf. Third, Tomatsu Yamamoto, Tom Ski. Fourth was Norm Yee. Fifth, Jack Arlick. Sixth, Michael McFarland. And seventh, Jason Ward. That was Sports It 1200 GP, motor number one. Motor number two is on the line. All right, Moto 1 results are posted on the pit board. Moto number 1 results are posted on the pit board.
Wow, a hatch from Wolfie Beach buoy battle.
We need some holders to the line, please. Holders.
I'll hold you, Kurt.
Holding it on, holding it up.
All right, the Wolfie Beach goes to Dan Nolden. I'm assuming that's a Dan kid.
Dean Nolden.
Goes to Dink. Blosion stickers.
Oh, sweet.
And a bracelet. They go to Jade Liu.
Nolden Wolfie hat.
Jade Lou, you come get your Blosion stickers.
Up next. All right, quick before the 20 minute, we're going to give away one more. Let's go.
20 minute or 20 second?
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
You're such a stickler for accuracy.
Aren't I, though? That's why that's...
Fistful of foam, Blosion freestyle, surf video. Those things are awesome. Pull one for us. Mylea Tinsley, come on down. More holders, please. One, at least one more holder to the line. Anybody who has the capability, please go to the line. More holders.
We can't go until we have them.
Another holder, please. We're going to do another of the videos. This one completely different. Fistful of foam by Blosion, but this one's upside down.
Chang Lu!
Chang Lu, you are up. Jet ski action. Lumpy's box is still here for anybody who hadn't given the gate fee to us yet. Come on over. We'll look forward to putting it in the acrylic box. I want to give a big shout out to John Lee, who before he left to Las Vegas this morning dropped $100 in the box. Thanks so much, John. A class act for you. All right, sports set, 1200 GP.
Engines are revving. 20 second board up and down. All right.
Tomatsu Yamamoto on that gold blaster with the lead. Behind him, Doug Wolf. Thomas Pageon getting pushed wide. Normie and Pageon going at it, but Pageon hooks up and leaves him.
Psycho Ward making his way.
Was that Psycho?
That was Psycho.
Was he on a different boat?
No, he was on his. Yeah, oh, it is a different boat.
Yeah. I thought so. I thought his boat. Wow, Tomatsu Yamamoto on the gorgeous gold ski clinic triple cylinder Yamaha blaster. He has got the whole shot. Whoa, getting a little squirrely. Oh, look at this, the battle for second, side by side. Doug Wolf,
losing
Thomas Pageon.
Pageon by a nose.
Pageon got the inside. Oh, Pageon,
wow.
Sticking it in. Oh, going around him on the outside with that XIR.
He is doing whatever he can.
Jack Garlic, oh, Norm Yee.
Oh, boy. Slowing down gives Ward a chance to fly by him.
Well, I'd say paddle by him. I don't know what's going on, but that I think that's his recreational boat, the 900.
Oh, yeah, it seems like it. Out for a stroll.
Yeah, out for a walk. Hey, points are points. Sorry, we don't know what happened to Jason's boat. We'll try and find out before the end of the day. Boy, Tomatsu Yamamoto going at it.
Flying.
He is attacking this course, as is Thomas Pageon. Pageon, here comes Pageon and Wolf.
Wolf not letting go, trying to pass Pageon and make it into the number two spot.
Yeah. Doug Wolf trying to keep his speed up around the corner when he jumps the pump wash to be able to stay close going on the far side. But I'll tell you what, Thomas Pageon's got that little Sea-Doo X4 hull hooked up and accelerating away. Psycho Ward having a nice leisurely stroll on his 900. Norm Yee definitely having issues. Looking down disappointedly at his vote.
It's too bad. Normally is usually a big contender for that number one spot.
He normally is. That's why we call him Normal Norman.
Yes.
Well, abs, too. That's why we call him abnormal. All right.
Thomas Pageant, or Tomatsu Yamamoto, sorry, flying through. Thomas Pageant behind him.
Oh, no, Pageant. Oh, Pageant having to take the bonus.
Which means that Doug Wolf has the chance to pass him up, which he does.
Pageant, one of the only people to go through the penalty boys at no wake speed. Good job on his part. Oh, Jason Ward on the 900, making his way here. 5-6-7 to the line. 5-67 to the line.
So that should be Steve Watson, Jamie Pierney, Matt Gerwin, Keith Lagagna, Mark Hanges, Kevin Andretti, Jerry Gregorio, Bill Austin, Jeff Loader, Scott Chewy, and Matt Rawlings.
Wow, Norm Yee really having some bad mechanicals. Moving out of the way. Great sportsmanship. Now watch this battle. Doug Wolf has got Thomas Pageant coming up behind him now.
Yeah, something is definitely wrong with Norm's boat. It was sounding funny as he went by here.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, no.
Technical term.
Sorry, I saw a stand-up going towards the rocks at speed. Here comes Jason Ward. Tomatsu Yamamoto getting a white flag. One lap to go. It's been a little while since Tom has won a race, but he's on it now. Behind him, Doug Wolf and Thomas Pageant, and Pageant on a mission. Doug Wolf got by, and he'd sure like to reel him back in.
We've got the white flag out, too.
Oh, yeah. Now, next time we see Norm, next time we see Tomatsu Yamamoto, it'll be because he's winning this race.
All right, here he comes, a battle out there. Let's go put your hands together for our winner, Tomatsu Yamamoto.
Look at the battle for second.
Wow.
Oh. And Thomas Pageant barely edges out Doug Wolf, I would say by about a half a foot, maybe a foot max.
That was incredible.
Perfectly right here. What? All right, 5-67 should be on the line. 5-6-7s, second moto. Can you leave me here? And the 550s are off. Looks like Steve Watson with Mark Hodges and Phil Ryder down.
No, he just went shoulder to the water and popped right back up there.
Yeah, I'm just surprised that the horn went that quickly for the 650s.
And the 750s.
Now the 750s. That is not 20 seconds per. Oh, Ryder down far left that side. Oh! Doug, who was that?
A Ryder.
Yeah.
All right, the first group making their way through the back of the course on their way over here, going through the splits. Who is that in first place, Kurt?
I think it's Steve Watson, based on the height on the ski and his riding style.
You've got the glasses on, so you can see better than me at this point. All right.
That is Steve Watson, followed by Mark Hodges.
Who is then followed by the Jerry Gregorio. And then Jeff Loader.
Who's followed through by Jamie Pierney.
Here comes Scott Shuey and Matt Gerwin.
Shuey having to take the penalty, boy. What's that?
All right, Steve Watson coming through, still holding on to his lead, followed by Mark Hodges, who is doing what he can to get past Watson there for the number one spot. What a battle right now, too, between Pierney and... Oh, Ryder down as he was trying to come around that turn.
That's right. That was the 86.
No, it was Jerry Gregorio, the 101 boat.
Right. No, Kevin Andrade had just gone by, and then Gregorio went down. There's no love lost between those two. It wouldn't surprise me to see a huge fist fight in the pits. No, just kidding. Who's that?
All right, making their way to the line should be the X2s.
X2s, to the line, please. All the X2s.
Gerling, Toline, Yamamoto, Wolf, Harden, Summers, Wilson, Wilson, Toline, AJ Summers.
I guess what you're telling me, if your name's not Wilson, you only got a 50-50 shot at getting into class.
Exactly.
White flag out, one left to go. Steve Watson continues to lead, but here's Jamie Pierney. Pierney trying to make the move. It's taken all race long to get up, and look at this. Watson all of a sudden starts pulling the trigger. Lap rider between them. Let's see what happens with Pierney. There's Watson. About 3 seconds back is Pierney.
Feel the break, feel the break, feel the break, and I got All right, here they come, folks, making their way through that last split.
Is that Watson out front?
I believe you are correct, Kurt.
I don't know. It could be Pierney. Alright. Checker flag coming out.
Alright.
It's Watson, then Pierney.
Alright, coming in third on the
83, that's Kevin Andrade.
77 boat of Mark Hanges. .40 boat of Keith Lagana. All right, and we should have all the X2 Army on the line. Every X2 should be on the line if you're racing.
All right, X2's on the line. We need some holders to the line. X2's. We need some holders to the line, please. Yeah, for those of you that are leaving early, after you've boxed up your stuff, if you look around your pit and the area around your car, if you see anything on the ground, any garbage, please pick it up. Throw it in the appropriate receptacle so someone else doesn't have to do it later. It'd be great. We've got a good group of people that respect the venues that allow us to be there, but let's not change that now. Yeah, all the way, 10 miles an hour, all the way out to the pavement. So all the way through the farm, 10 miles an hour. I thought that was kind of a given, but perhaps not.
On the line, we have the X2 Army, but in staging should be the 900 Novice Stand and the 1100 Legend Stand.
Combined. How much you want to bet that phone comes out of that pocket? Yeah. Okay.
All right.
And how'd you know we were talking about you? But you know what? You guys can't stand there while the races are going on. There you go.
All right, 20-second board up and down. There they go. Battle between
looks like Gerling and Wolf.
And
whoa, Wilson.
Wow.
Sammy Wilson just getting control. Wow, that thing started to die. It was headed towards the rocks. It picked back up, and he is on the throttle. Yeah, we need the 900 novice, 1100 legends to the line. 900 novice, 1100 legends to the line. You guys are up next.
And after them is going to be the SEXP expert and the sprint sit runabouts.
Both of you. All right, here we go. It's Gerling, Wolf.
All right.
And Toline.
Wow. Not
GWT.
Giving up there.
Look at this. Sammy Wilson going by Jesse Harden.
Battle out there for second place, and it looks like Wolf's just not going to let him go. All right, here they come, folks, across the block.
Uh-oh, Steve Gerling, we're getting a black flag here. Brian Toline, seeing the flag coming in. Sammy Wilson looks over like, what's wrong? Nothing wrong for him.
Tomatsu Yamamoto just coming by, making his way around the turn.
Yeah, he got moved up into third.
Greg Summers.
And fourth. I got an X2 seat for sale up here. It's a raffle prize. Oh, that's Jesse's seat, or Sammy's seat, I think. We have an injury. We're going to stop the race.
Please hold while we take care of everything out here. Make sure Doug's all right.
All right, I know we're all concerned, but let's definitely give Doug some space.
Guys, please clear the beach. We need to give Doug and our Team Orange enough room to see what's going on and assess the situation. So if everybody else could just go back, we know that you're concerned, but if you could just please go back to your boats or your pits, it would be greatly appreciated.
Basically, if you're not an EMT or part of Team Orange, let's give them some space.
All right, while we're waiting to hear what the situation is, let's do some raffles. We got some Blosion stickers. So let's go ahead and grab a name for that. All right, our first name, Lizzie Harden. Who's it going to be? Steve Gerling, Steve and Nicole, one of you have won a prize.
Steve Gerling, come on over, get your prize.
All right, next, Jackie, what's up? Another Blosion sticker pack. And a bracelet. That is going to go to someone named Chen Liu. Chen Liu, come on up and grab your prize. X2 to the line for the green, white checkered. X2's back to the line, please.
X2's to the line. We are going to do a green-white checker. X2's to the line, please.
All right, let's call one more gift. What are they winning, Jackie? Talon Chambers. Talon, you are winning Blosion swag.
You say Talon's a wiener?
I did. Wiener, wiener, chicken dinner.
That's right. Talon Chambers, come on down. What else we got over here?
Another Blosion movie. Fistful of Foam. Yeah, I'd like to say thanks.
Yeah, big shout out to John Dady and the whole crew up there.
Mel Harden.
Mel Harden wins it. Gotta love it. All right,
Jesse Wilson, can you come on over, please? Jesse. Jesse Wilson.
Up next. What are we giving away?
Mark Hanges.
I believe he's on the line.
Oh, well, when he's off the line, he can come win a prize. We'll hold it for you.
Love it. Who's up next? What are we giving away? Oh, we're giving away a small child. I like that. You're right. Reasonably tall child.
Our last set of Blosion stickers and bracelet.
Brock Austin. B-Rock.
All right, we've got Jesse Wilson switching out boats. He's gonna be riding Doug's boat right now, since Doug is otherwise occupied.
How do you like that? Doug's on the beach and providing sponsorship at the same time.
Very nice.
Man, the man that just keeps on giving.
All right, so once again, this is going to be a green, white checker.
Wow. That is a nice gift. Team Harden, seriously. That is a bad Mamma Jamma.
That is bad Mamma Jamma. Our big prize for today.
That's like a $1,400 winch.
25-pound capacity winch.
2,500.
Isn't that what I said?
No, you said 25 pounds.
It's been a long weekend.
Yeah, 25 pounds would lift up a tire. The
yes.
2,500 pounds will pick up the rest of the vehicle. Brock Austin?
Wow.
Brock Austin, what a great day for you, I am telling you. And I have the feeling you can put that winch to good use.
All right, here we go. Let's try this again. Play it
green,
safe, people.
Green, white, checker, X2, motto number 2. And go. No.
No. Yeah, woo. No. Now this
Whoa.
Time. Wow.
Steve Gerling, Sammy Wilson. Jesse Wilson, couldn't catch it. Looked like Tomatsu Yamamoto out there as well.
All right, here they come, folks.
Wow, going.
Coming through.
And Jesse Harden in second. And I believe that's Sammy.
All right,
Sammy
coming.
Wilson, Tomatsu Yamamoto, Jesse Wilson, Tyler Toline.
And straight from Idaho and New Jersey, we've got Steve Gerling's parents cheering him on.
Steve, what's that? Harding? No. Yes, Harden. Yeah, Jesse Harden. I thought you were saying, yeah, I held him. That's my guy. All right, that was Greg Summers rounding out the field there. All right, coming at us. Here he is, former world champion, new father, Steve Gerling, getting the white flag behind him. Jesse Harden, rider down. Sammy Wilson, Sammy Wilson going down and getting back up. Jesse Wilson. Look at this, the Wilson brothers going at it. Sammy on the inside, Jesse on the outside. Sammy holds tight. Jesse sticks it but stays up. Final lap of the X2 race.
All right, who's it gonna be?
Looks like Gerling. And he's extended. And then I believe that is Sammy Wilson in second.
Jesse.
Jesse Harden, I'm sorry.
Jesse
Harden in second.
Wow.
And then, actually way back off them, Sammy Wilson, then Jesse Wilson. Jesse riding Doug Wolf's boat.
All right, and your winner today is Steve Gerling. Or did you just say that, Curtin? I didn't hear.
All right. It's Gerling, Harden, Wilson, Toline, Yamamoto, and Summers. Wow. What a ride. What a race.
Great race, guys.
Gotta love it. Up next, 900, 1100 legend combined.
All right. 900 and 1100. So Chad Campbell, Matt Rawlings, Dan Nolden, Bob Fasalo, Bill Austin, Mike Furman, and David Tolley. After them in staging right now is going to be the SCXP expert, Jesse Wilson, Bill Wilson, and Rick Ignacio.
Game on. All right, gonna take a look. The final winner of the day for the raffle prize is Thomas Pagen. Thomas Pagen, you're gonna enjoy this $25 certificate for dead meat. And what's the name of the place? I see it. Fagundes Meat and Catering in Manteca. Thomas Page, and you're going to stop by there at the next race. Brock got all his stuff? Okay. So Thomas Page, next barbecue's on you. Right behind him. That's true. It said Page, and it may not have been Thomas. All right. All right, in the 900 novice stand, Moto One winner was Tanya Wadier. Wait a minute. One without a permanent scar, and then you miss me while you were looking for yourself out there. All right, in the 900 class, Moto One winner, Matt Rawlings. Second, Chad Campbell. In the legends, first was Bill Austin. Second, Bob Vassallo. Third, David Vitale. Fourth, Mike Furman. And fifth, Dan Nolden. That was Moto number one. We need the SCXP and Sprint Sit to the line. Or Sprint Sits and the SCXP to the line. All right, here we go. 900 novice stand, 1100 legends. 20-second sign is up. Who will it be? Vasallo, Austin,
itching to go.
Vitale. Who's getting a hole shot? Oh, Austin's got position.
Like...
Vasallo's got the speed. Vasallo with the drive. Here comes Austin. Opening up that hydrospace, driving down.
Wow.
It's got to be close. Rider in the water. That's David Vitale, I believe. Per chance, we'll have to take a look. See, that might be Mike Furman. What are you doing with my fruit by the foot? Rainbow, how appropriate these days. Wow. Folks on the beach, give yourselves a hand. The raffle total today or the last 2 days, $425 going to Lumpy's Fund. Thank you
that
so much.
Fantastic.
Really good job, guys. Thank you. And our thanks to everyone who gave products for us to raffle off. Out in front, Bob Asalo, followed by Bill Austin.
Follow
David Vitale, I believe, on the 70.
On the 700, yep.
700, not the 709. Matt Rawlings. He's leading the 900 novice. SCXP sprints it to the line.
Chad Campbell just coming through.
Mav, you need help? All right, we need Jesse Wilson and Bill Wilson to the line.
All right, Bob Vasallo and Bill Austin coming through. Bob Vasallo really doing a great job at holding that first place this weekend.
I'll tell you what, those two are going at it. The 605, Mike Furman. Furman, glad to see him back. He moves over and lets David Vitale by. Vitale, once again, one of the most improved riders this year. Bill Wilson cracking his knuckles, ready to smack somebody off the line.
All right, we've got our three racers on the line already for our next run.
Bill Wilson. All right, coming down the front straight. Side by side. Watch it as they come to the line. Yeah! Woo!
All right, Chad Campbell pushing through.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Chad did, but Dan Nolden just cruising around having some fun. Nolden going to take off after, after Bob Vasallo. The where, oh where, is Bill Austin. All right, Jill, they're coming down the front straightaway one more time. Who's it going to be?
Well, it looks like...
Who's it going to be?
Bob Vasallo.
Who's
it
going to be?
And then, but Bill Austin is really making it difficult for him, trying to push hard. Two more laps to go.
All right, two laps to go. Vasallo with the lead.
Austin in second.
Yeah, Bill Austin riding hard on that thing. You see him scooting down to the tray, getting a more of a tack position, coming into the front straightaway. Water roughed up a little bit. Here's Vitale stretching his back out. Oh, yeah. That cramping, that pain, that lower back pain starting to come into play here. Vitale way, way, way down in the tray, most of the way around the course. Matt Rawlings coming through with
Chad Campbell.
And look at the battle going here between
Dan
Furman
Nolden.
And Nolden. Yeah. Dan Nolden slowing down in the corner, waiting to have some fun. All right, we need some holders to the line, please. Holders to the line.
Hello, Kurt. All right, Bob Vasallo getting the white flag. Same with Bill Austin.
Bill Austin starting to catch up. He's got it. One lap to go if he's going to head off Bobasalo. And I'll tell you what, Bobasalo is on a
tear.
He's on a tear, a mission, a drive. He is hot, hot this weekend. Having said that, Austin did win the first moto. And he is within one buoy. Oh, look over on the far side.
Wow, it's a battle raging down there, Kurt. Who's
it
going to be?
It is a rager.
All right. Let's see. Oh, it's close. All right, Dan Nolden. And Mike Furman pushing hard to make it through.
All right, moving on.
Vasallo.
Vasallo with the win. Go ahead.
Oh, with his win, yet another win for today, and followed by Bill Austin in second place.
Good job by Chad Campbell, moving over, letting those two race all the way to the finish. Great sportsmanship by Chad.
All right, the 700 boat of Dave Vitale coming through. And happy. Happy to be finished.
Exceptionally happy. All right, coming up next, SCXP Expert, Sprint Set 1350. What can you tell us about the people on the line, Jill?
I can tell you that Jesse Wilson, Bill Wilson, and Rick Ignacio are going to be battling this one out. Jesse came in first in the first heat for his class. And then it was Bill Wilson and Rick Ignacio. So let's see the battle continue.
I'm sure it will. I was kind of thinking, who are the sponsors of these riders?
Thank you. Thank you for handing me that information. Sponsoring Jesse Wilson on the 808 boat is the Wilson Brothers Racing, Wolf Racing, Jet Pilot, Oakley Team Wilson. Bill Wilson on the 771 boat is sponsored by Jet Trim, HydroTurf, R&D, ODI Works, and Parker Yamaha. DJSA Racing, Jet Pilot, SunwindFire.com, West Coast Porting, SunwindRide.com, and the Tuner's Den all get together to sponsor Rick Ignacio on the 816 boat. On in staging right now should be race 6, 900 expert stand and 1100 intermediate stand. So if you are in 900 expert stand, your name is Chris Waddy or Bob Vasallo, Pete Zernick. And if you are 1100 intermediate stand, you are Mitch Jonas, Don Warney, and Dave Vitale. You guys should all be starting to think about getting ready to make it to the line.
Well, they better go to the line in just a moment. SCXP sprints it combined. And go, go. Go, go.
All right, Bill Wilson. Getting the jump on that start. Taking off. Look at him go, and Rick Ignacio trying to catch up with him there. Jesse Wilson making his way in that second start.
I'm sorry, did you say Jesse Ignacio and Maverick Wilson?
Yes, I did.
Okay. Because that's the way I was thinking about it, except backwards.
Yes.
Or sideways.
I just wanna run, hide it away. All right, and here they come, folks. And that, front set of splits. Let's see, who's it going to be? Bill Wilson holding the lead there, taking first place. And here comes Mav. Jesse Wilson giving the people on the beach a little splash.
Wow, Jesse Wilson running 58 second lap times, less than a minute.
Bill Wilson.
What? That's Bill out there?
58
nice.
Seconds. Quite impressive. All right, here they come, folks. The 58-second lapper, Bill Wilson, making his way through the checker buoys. Here comes Jesse Wilson and Rick Ignacio. Making that turn, all of them seem to be on full throttle, doing what they can to be that first one through those checker, past the checkered flag. Once again, if you are 900 expert stand or 1100 intermediate stand, you should be making your way to the line right now.
If that were you, what would your name be?
Your name would be Bob Vassallo, Pete Zernick, Chris Wattier, Ben Shembry, Thomas Pageant, Dave Vitale, Mitch Jones, and Dr. Don Warney. Wow, I cannot talk.
Look at this, Bill Wilson tearing it up out there. When it Bill Wilson and Bob Wilson, and they are really close. Look at this.
Quite
Bob
impressive.
Bob Wilson cutting hard. Well, Bill Wilson.
I actually think that Bob Wilson might be on the beach, and that's Jesse.
What? No.
That's not.
That's Bill.
Is it? Bill Wilson.
Wilson
and Bob Wilson?
And Bob Wilson. I know. Look at this, Bob Wilson out in front. Whoa, wide open.
All right, here comes Bill Wilson. Having to take the black buoy there.
And Bob Wilson takes the... Yeah, Bob Wilson takes the penalty boy and is chasing Bill Wilson down.
All right, following up is Rick Ignacio.
All right, look at them coming at us side by side. Bill Wilson, Bob Wilson, Bob Wilson, Bill Wilson. BW in either case, Bill Wilson on the sprint set, Bob Wilson on the SCXP, and Bob Wilson's going to win it.
All right, we got the white flag out, folks. Last lap.
Woo! God love that. Two different classes.
All right, I'd like to thank everybody already on the line right now. Including Mitch Jonas, Don Werney. I think I saw Pete Zernick down there, Bob Vassallo. If you are not one of those people, then you should be making your way down here. So, Chris Wattier and Dave Vitale.
See, Mitch Jonas is over there. Don Werner.
Isn't the race over? Jim, are they taking a victory lap? All right, Robert with some acrobatics out there. All right, happy to see so many people down on the line in the 900 expert and 1100 intermediate.
All right, well, that was fun. Bob Wilson, do you enjoy yourself?
All right. Just.
Happy ending.
So it's.
Well done. Game on.
Going to be starting in just a second with the 900s first. Whistle. Rev them up.
All right, once again, 900, 1100 mixed class.
Gonna wait just a matter of a few seconds before the second class goes. 20 second board up. Bob Vassallo making that jump.
Pete Cernick in tow. Here comes David Vitale, hard on the inside. Vitale in front of Jonas. Jonas trying to swing it back. Not quite going to be able to make it. Up next.
Up next is going to be.
Down on the far right-hand side of the course, making the turn. Who we got? Who's he going to be?
So making their way to the line should be the Sport Sit 800 Novice. And in staging should be the Fast Stand 1100 GP Expert. So Sport Sit 800 to the line.
Last two races of the day. Look at this. Battle raging out there.
Bob
Vassallo coming out first.
Not by much, though. Pete Cernick giving him a battle.
Pete Cernick in a full-on attack mode with David Vitale behind him. Look at the top three within two buoys. Mitch Jonas catching up, right?
Yes, he is. Trying to make his way.
All
Thank you, Jacob Blue, for making your way down to the line. All right, looks like Bob Vassallo is still holding firm on his lead.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Pete Zernick. Zernick really throwing out there, trying to make something happen. You can see the effort he's putting out.
But Bob Vassallo just taking it away this weekend. Here comes on the 700
Vitaly.
Boat.
Or is it Fiddly? From
it's
Little Italy.
Fiddly.
Whoa. Mitch Jonas digging a hip in over there.
All right, thank you, Donnie Miller, for making your way down here, too. Once again, if you are Sports Hit 800 novice, you should be making your way to the line. And in staging should be the Fast Stand 1100 GP. So Jacob Blue, Brandon Miller, Donnie Miller, Eric Stegman, Don Miller, and James Arlick should be making their way to the line. In staging, Ian Roberts, Pete Zernick, Chris Watery, who are out on the water right now, and Jeremy Dixon.
Holders to the line,
holders.
Please. We need some holders. As Bob Vassallo is starting to pull away from Pete Zernick. I think Zernick got caught up in some traffic over there. And David Vitaly,
he is
making a move.
Yes. Doesn't want to be in third for long.
Mitch Jonas kind of putting a pass on there too.
Yes. And here comes Don Warney. Look at them go on the far side, ladies and gentlemen.
Gentlemen.
Coming around that turn.
The magics of evaporative cooling. Dude, it works.
Bob Vassallo continuing to dominate through the course as he's making his way through, continuing to hold first place. Here he comes.
He's looking over like, is this race ever going to end?
Right? Here comes Pete Zernick, Dave Vitaly.
Mitch Jonas.
And see Don Warney finishing up the yellow buoys. We just want to take a second to thank this class. They have been exceptional all weekend. Not a single problem. They have come to the line when called. They are just way on top of the game. Not that y'all aren't great, but they have been exceptional.
Yes, sir. Holders to the line, please. Some more holders. Vitaly going to try and make a move on Zernick on the last lap. Oh, he stuck it just a little. I don't know if Pete knows how close David Vitaly is.
I don't think he does. All right, holders, please come help these phenomenal racers that are on the line right now.
I'll tell you what, this is going to be a fun time coming through this slalom section between David Vitaly and Pete Zernick. Let's face it, the 55, Bob Vassallo way out in front. He's gone. Okay, here comes, is that Pete?
Is it? Who could it be now?
It would be Pete and Vitaly. First, it's Vassallo.
Vassallo hitting the water with his shoulder as he's coming through,
just
getting the checkered
good
flag.
Watch this. Right near the end here, who's it going to be? Oh, no.
Wow.
David Batali.
By a nose.
I'll tell you what, we are talking about most improved. Yeah, no doubt. David Batali is in seventh heaven. I think Pete Zerna could be the first one to congratulate him because David Batali has definitely stepped his game up.
Yes.
We still need holders down there.
Raise your hand if you need a holder.
Raise your holder if you need a hand.
All right, here comes Don Morney coming through.
And David Batali, second for the second time. Apparently has too much fuel on the boat and he needs to keep running it before he lands. Kind of like an airplane. Who knows?
All right, on the water, we have Jacob Blue, Brandon Miller, Donnie Miller, Eric Stegman, Don Miller, James Arluck. So I'd say this is a Miller flash.
Somebody better give David Batali a black flag or a red flag. They should just keep racing.
Here he comes back. European style.
Yeah. Folks, when he comes around, give David Batali a big round of applause. Tell you what, he is one of the most improved riders this year. Give him a hand when he comes on shore.
Happy birthday. Whistle blowing. All right, Kurt, who is that with the
easy
horse?
That's Jacob Blue out in
wow.
front. Eric Stegman in second. Donnie Miller in third, Brandon Miller in fourth.
And that is James Arluck next.
Yeah, and Arluck goes by Miller. Which Miller? I don't know. They're all Miller.
Hey, you got 60% chance we're calling that one.
That's right. We need 1,100.
1,100's to the line.
Fast Stand GP to the line. Final race of the day.
Ian, Pete. Chris, Jeremy,
Chris,
all right, here they come, folks, making his way first through the line is Jacob Blue, continuing to hold that first place position, followed on the number 15 by Donnie Miller, then Eric Stegman.
Whoa, Stegman taking the naughty boy penalty, boys.
James Arluck and Brandon Miller battling it out.
Like that.
Like a boss.
Don
and then
Miller?
Don Miller. on the 32. We think it's a 32 boat.
It is a 32 boat.
His feet kind of hide the numbers.
Right. But only one number at a time.
Right.
All right. Fast and GP to the line. Final mottos of the day.
Ian, Pete, Chris, Jeremy.
Come on down. Jacob Lil out in front and leaving it.
He really is. Feel like we just said his name a second ago, calling the last time he went through the buoys. All right, and in staging right now, ladies and gentlemen, is the last race for the day, for the weekend. This next one on the line is the last race.
Right. Yeah.
So excited about the juniors. I wanted them to race
Brandon
again.
Brandon Miller having mechanical issues. That thing is not getting any speed at all. I unfortunately wish I could tell Brandon, hey, you might want to stop and check your pump. Jacob Lowe holding his lead.
Great job this weekend for Jacob Lowe.
Donnie Miller coming in second.
All right, next is Eric Stademan and James Arlick. All right, and on the line for our last race of the day, folks, should be Ian, Pete, Chris, and Jeremy.
Brandon Miller still nursing that boat along.
All right, here comes Don Miller, letting a rider go by him. Jacob Lowe, nice racing out there. Sportsmanship. Donnie Miller coming through, holding second position.
Looking back, looks like Eric Stegman.
James Arlick.
Need something that I can confess. Turn on my sleeves, I stained red. From all the truth that I've said. Come by it honestly, I said. Thought you saw me wink, no. I've been on the brink, so tell me what you want to hear. Something that will light those ears.
Brandon Miller coming through. Trying to work his boat. All right, white flag out for Jacob Lowe on his last lap for the last race of our last day.
Right, one lap to go. Donnie Miller trying to chase down Jacob Lowe. Not gonna happen.
Nope, not gonna happen.
Did I say not gonna happen?
Don Miller coming through. Here comes Eric Stegman. Third spot. James Arlick.
We'll be right back. All right, white flag out for Brandon Miller.
All right, we've got the checker, Jacob Blue, your wire-to-wire winner for this heat.
Checker flag for Donnie Miller.
Right, and it looks like we've got Brock Austin joining us for the last race. Making his way, feeling better after last night. All right, Eric Stegman coming through, holding third. James Arlick and Don Miller just finishing up. All right, ladies and gentlemen, on the line right now for our last race of the weekend, the Fastian 1100 GP Experts.
Jen Lambert expressing his appreciation to the Fast Stand GPs. Either that or praying to the sun god, I'm not sure which.
Maybe a little of both?
Little of both. I know, great weather, great racing, great food, great fun, great company. Reasonably good announcing, at least, well, great onto the left of me. Really a lot of fun this weekend. And you know what? I really want to send out a personal thanks to everybody that joined the raffle. Did you hear that, Jim? $425 in a raffle.
All right, guys, engines are going. 20-second board is up. All right, they are off, people, for that last race. What a battle out there. All
oh, no. Where's Bob Masalo?
Right. We got, it looks like Brock Austin there in the lead at the moment. They were going so fast and so close together. Could not tell who is what the order was.
Ooh, I see a Brockski there.
Yep. That bright orange, great color.
Who's the other one? Is that Pete?
All right, Brock making his way first through the buoys. Followed by Chris Wattier.
Then Ian Roberts. Jeremy Dixon. And
Pete Zernick.
Zeke Pernick.
Thomas Pajan.
Thomas Pajan.
What a battle it's going to be out there, folks, for this last race. All great racers and competitive, yet all friends. Here they come through the split. Looks like Brock Austin still holding tight to his lead. Chris Wattier pushing his way, trying to keep up, and hopefully at some point pass Brock.
Brock Austin setting up way before the corner and driving through it.
Battle there between Ian and Chris Wattier, and then Pete and Thomas Bajan. Or no, sorry, Pete and Jeremy.
Jeremy Dixon and Pete Cernick. Brock Austin way out in front. He's starting to stretch his lead every corner, every straightaway. Chris Wattier in second. Wow.
59 seconds.
Brock Austin breaking the 1 minute mark on a stand up here. Got to love it.
Oh, and apparently that's his slow ski.
Wow.
Brock, we saw him less than a minute ago. Really extending that lead, too. Here comes Chris Wattier. Oh, no.
Ian
got
Roberts.
Passed by Ian Roberts.
And Pete Cernick, Chris Wattier.
Something must have happened.
Chris loves this water.
He does.
Not.
All right, here comes Jeremy Dixon.
And a dejected Chris Wattier coming to shore. Unfortunate.
I was right, he was coming, just not at the speed that he was hoping for.
Brock Austin, once again, he's getting the two laps to go sign. Brock now officially in another country.
I think you're right.
Ian Roberts trying hard to get a visa, but he's not even knocking on the door.
No one's letting him in.
Pete Cernick, he's in a separate zip code as well.
All right, Jeremy followed by Thomas Pageon.
Thomas Pageon making his presence known.
All right, Jim pulling the white flag out, meaning this is the last lap of the weekend, folks. Brock staying strong on that as he takes his turn.
Oh, and Brock continues to lead on the other side. Three quarters a lap to go. Brock Austin has been unheaded in this race. Ian Roberts in second. At this point, a distant second. Pete Cernick is like on a lonely ride right now.
Right. No one.
I don't even think he can see anybody in front of him when he makes a turn.
Just barely, because I think they're about to make that last turn. All right, Jeremy coming through. Thomas Pageon. Brock making his way through the last few of the split out there. And it looks like Ian following his wake, but won't be able to catch Brock, who takes first for this race. Ian really closed the gap a little bit there on that for that second place.
A little
win.
Bit, but I bet you that Brock would backed off some. Just the way that it happens.
All right, here comes Pete on his black 149 boat in third place. As he gets that black and white checker. Jeremy Dixon making it through, slowing down. And then Thomas Pagen. And ladies and gentlemen, we are done.
That is official. So for everyone who enjoyed the weekend, we thank you so much for coming.
Show us how much you enjoyed it by cleaning up after yourselves.
Exactly. As usual, we can use some assistance in pulling buoys, loading up the race trailer. Want to point out a few things. There's some beautiful plaques that are going to be the presents or the awards for this race. However, based on the late hour, they will be either delivered to you if you're close by Jim's place, or if you want them sent, if you're far away, he'd be happy to do it. Otherwise, he'll bring them to the next race. Those things are awesome looking.
Yes, very nice. So once again, thank you everyone for coming out, for showing your support. Our Jet Effect tribute for Lumpy Sturgill. We really appreciate it. It's been a great weekend, and thank you, Eagle Lakes, for having us.
Our thanks to all the DJSA crew. My personal thanks to my co-announcer and master chef, Jill.
Thank you very much,
really appreciate the assistance. It really makes it a lot more fun.
It does.
And, of course, as always, we thank Maverick for all the video, this live streaming. He is the man, internationally known. We couldn't do it without him. And headbutting the steel. I know he thought it was wood, but.
Thanks for my number two over there in the Outlaw Cafe, Amanda
Absolutely.
Stellhorn.
Absolutely, Amanda Stellhorn, her husband Robert, and all of Team Orange.
Yes.
You know, the unheralded Team Orange that do everything to keep our riders safe, set up the course, take the course down. And. Of course, Jim Lambert.
Yeah.
Don't want to forget our scorers. Maria, the head of all the paperwork. Thanks so much, Maria, for everything you do.
It's been fantastic to have Mandy back.
I was just going to say, having Mandy here and Tammy here, it's, you know.
We've got an excellent team here. All right, course is closed, folks. So yep. If you want to get out on the water without a ski, now is your time.
Yep. It's over, Rover. So once again, if you can, give us a hand. Assist Team Orange, and they'll start pulling the buoys. We got a lot of them here. To have that kind of course, you got to have a lot of buoys. You have a lot of buoys, then you got to have a lot of anchors. You got a lot of anchors, you got to have a lot of rope.